Julia, we closed down at 1.4% or so. Not a great day.
It was a risk of day for the Aussie share market. 1.4% loss, and we saw $4.9 billion worth of stock being traded. So some pretty decent volumes going through on a pretty bad result. So not a good sign for the Australian market. We did see offshore markets seeing losses overnight. In fact, the Toronto, the DAX, as well as the NASDAQ, down around that 1% mark. But really, the selling started on our market yesterday after China downgraded its growth forecast from 8% to 7.5%. And the selling continued into today's session. So concerns about global growth still dominating our market. And if we have a look at the sectors which contributed the most to the loss, the material sector was hardest hit. We saw the likes of BHP, Billiton, Rio Tinto down by 2.3%. It also didn't help that we saw some comments coming out of China Steel today during our session, saying that China Steel's still asking for a cut to iron ore prices. It's already got it from Vale, and it's still asking BHP, Billiton and Rio Tinto for those cuts in iron ore prices. But on the flip side, it does see a rebound in steel prices and steel demand in the second half of the year. But that material space really dragging quite severely on our market. And of course, that interest rate decision was the big event of our day. If we have a look at the Aussie share market, we saw the decision at 2:30, and you can see we saw another leg down. The Australian market really closing at the lows of the session and just above that 4,200 mark.
RBA decision and the statement that was subsequently released, when we'll also be joined by Paul Bloxham from HSBC. I just wanted to touch on the Aussie dollar. Julie, you mentioned the movements that we saw pre and post that RBA decision. Look, how much of an impact is that Australian dollar, do you think, having on the broader equity market at the moment?
If we have a look at the Aussie dollar, it was a pretty dramatic reaction. And if we have a look at the Aussie dollar today, intraday, this is what it looks like. So that 2:30 decision came out, and you can see the Aussie dollar dropping below that 106 cent mark. So when you get a decision which is in line with market expectations, and you see risks still selling off in terms of the Aussie dollar and the equity markets, it's quite a short-term bearish signal for the markets. So it does look like the markets perhaps looking at global risks. We did see China's forecast being cut. And of course, the next couple of days is going to be crucial in terms of Greece. We do see the deadline for that invitation for restructuring to private creditors expiring at 9 p.m. Greek time on the 8th of March. So the next couple of sessions, Europe probably going to be back in focus as well. But that higher Aussie dollar, quite difficult, making it quite difficult for a lot of companies which are listed on our exchange that do most of their business offshore. And in particular, we've seen some strong sell-offs in the healthcare sector, the information technology sector, because of the higher Aussie dollar. And in fact, if we have a look at the past earnings season, we have seen that high Aussie dollar crimping into margins as well. A bit of a pullback in the Aussie dollar, but really no expectations that we're going to drop below parity. And that's because if we have a look all over the world, well, today we saw the Reserve Bank keeping rates unchanged, but elsewhere we are still seeing stimulus, whether it's in the form of falling interest rates or in the form of quantitative easing or asset purchase programs. So the rest of the world seems to be concentrating on stimulus while Australia's holding steady. And that should lend some support to the Aussie dollar. Unfortunately, not too good news for a lot of companies on our exchange in the equity markets, with the Aussie dollar still relatively high.
Julia, in terms of the investors out there at the moment, obviously hearing you talk and a lot of other forecasts saying they don't expect to see that Australian dollar drop below parity with the greenback for at least 2 years. What are some ways that they can cash in on it? Excuse the horrible pun there, but is there a way to benefit the average investor by having this strong Aussie dollar at the moment?
Well, I guess one way is going on
besides
holidays and the power of the Aussie dollar. The power of the Aussie dollar means that it does become a lot harder for retailers, because the strength of the Aussie dollar means we can buy a lot more offshore as well. But that strength in the Aussie dollar really quite reflective of what's going on around the world, and that is that we are seeing quantitative easing coming out of the US, out of England, out of Japan, and the LTRO coming out of Europe. So still seeing quite a bit of stimulus in terms of the rest of the world, and the Aussie, well, we're not printing any money over here and we're keeping interest rates stable. So I guess a positive signal in terms of our economy. But in terms of stocks, what we have seen over the last 18 months is this downgrading cycle by analysts. And if we have a look at the earnings season that has just passed, there's been a downgrade to FY12 earnings growth from around about just over 7% to about 3.5%. So it does still look like FY13 earnings are still looking relatively high. So we've probably got still a little bit left to go. in that that downgrade cycle. But on the flip side, we are seeing a lot of companies looking like bargains, and we're seeing a lot of takeover merger and acquisition activity and interest, and that's just showing how low valuations are in some of the sectors at the moment.